You know, in Hollywood, they call it the it factor. Buck had it.
Oh, he sure did. And now Buck O'Neill's name could go on a bridge thousands of people use every day.
Yeah, while other efforts to rename the Broadway Bridge have pretty much failed, new at 10, 41 Action News anchor Richard Sharp shows us why this time it could be different.
The beauty of its iconic triple arches is often overlooked by hurried drivers.
It's been around for a long time.
Simply a means for 45,000 people a day to get to and from the Kansas City skyline that acts as its backdrop.
Where it heads into, you know, from the downtown airport right into the skyline, seems like it's iconic for Kansas City.
State Senator Ryan Silvey.
Nobody asked us to do it.
And Jason Holzman, whose districts lie on opposite ends of the bridge, are working to get it renamed after another Kansas City icon, Buck O'Neill.
He's been such a huge part of the history of this town.
No, I wasn't that good.
Buck was famous.
Probably one of the best ambassadors Kansas City's ever had.
To Ollie Gates, he was a great friend.
Very personable guy.
Gates still remembers the day he met Buck.
I was 14 years old.
It was 1946.
I was working in a restaurant.
Gates Barbecue.
Buck came in.
The star player was flirting.
Kissing all the ladies and whatnot. He grabbed my mother and he kissed my mother, and my father took exception to that. So that's how I met Buck.
Ollie says it was Buck's golf swing that describes him best.
He had a saying when he hit the ball down the middle of the fairway, down the geometric center.
The geometric center.
Pretty honest guy.
Straightforward.
Straight down the middle. I enjoyed Buck because he always had a lot of nice things to say about people.
Driving across the Broadway Bridge with regularity.
Bob Kendrick from the Negro League Baseball Museum said,
it's hard to explain.
Buck O'Neill had something.
You know what it is, but you don't know exactly what it is.
Few people have.
In Hollywood, they call it
the it factor.
Buck had it.
Buck had a distinguished career in the Negro Leagues.
Joined the Monarchs in 1938.
And broke barriers as the first black major league scout and
first African-American coach.
Then Ken Burns used him in a documentary about baseball.
He was 82 years old, and America fell in love with Buck O'Neill.
Another interesting fact about this, Buck O'Neill ended his career in 1955. This bridge was being built that year and opened to the public the very next year, 1956.
While other efforts to rename the Broadway Bridge have failed, State Senator Ryan Silvey hopes Buck's reputation, his ability to bring people together,
it's kind of apropos that it's a bridge,
will help make the difference this time.
He helped bridge so many communities.
But maybe it will inspire them to look up Buck O'Neill.
I'm Richard Sharp, 41 Action News.
What a fantastic story. Well, the bill to rename the bridge has already passed in committee, and it is now waiting to be heard by the state Senate.